you're blowing constant pressure into this mouthpiece. So the only thing that is important with your armature and the bagpipes is the strength of it.
Oh, okay.
And that's one of the, I mean, you're talking, everybody thinks that it's so hard to play the bagpipes. The hardest working muscle to play the bagpipes is probably your lip. Literally, you cannot play on the Highland bagpipes starting out. You can't pick up a Highland bagpipe and learn on the bagpipes because your lip's not strong enough to play it.
So it's more than like blowing up a balloon. It's intense.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
It's a weird muscle to try and strengthen. You just get it by playing, by practicing. And that's why you start on the practice chamber. It's much less air. That's one of the things that's kind of different about it. I played the flute before, and with the flute, it's all about tying the notes and whatever. With a bagpipe, there's none of that. If you want to go from an A and you want to go like Jingle Bells, dot, 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 you have to do movements between them, which are called grace notes, that don't take up any timing in the music, but are a presence, especially when you have five and even in Pibroch, seven, eight, nine noted movements that are not supposed to take up any sound. So that's when you get that really bubbly noise. For instance, Scott Labrego's da ba da 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 da. That ba da is called a tarluath. It's four notes. That's not supposed to take up any time. So you sort of have to cut just a smidgen off one of the front of one of the notes or the back end of another note to fit it in there. And it's basically the separation between the A and the A, because it goes da 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 da. Instead of going ta 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 ta, it's, you're doing it all with your fingers. A grace note is a single note.
Okay, all right, all right.
Da, and you just lift up, basically a grace note, there's A grace notes, there's G grace notes, D grace notes, E grace notes. And then there are, anytime you combine more than one of little fast movements, they have a different name. Like, there, for every single note, there's what's called a doubling. There's a G doubling, which is you lift up this finger and this finger. There's an A doubling, which is this finger, and you go to a B doubling, it's this finger, C is this finger, and there's probably 30, 40 different movements that go between notes. And it's the most difficult. Learning the notes is not the difficult part with bagpipes, it's learning the notes between the notes. So, grace notes, I'll do a grace note scale. And you listen to the sound between the notes. That's just one note between there, and then there's doublings between each, and then you got. Doubling sounds just two notes. And then after that, there's not triplings or anything like that.
Okay.
But you asked about the lumloth. And that is, it's a three-noted, I'll show it to you. It's probably easier than telling you. If you go from an E, and you want to separate it by a lumloth, E, lumloth, E, it sounds like this. And then a C lumloth would be like this. When you do an A to an A with a lumloth, it's got a specific unique name called a grip. And that's just, it's the same thing, but. Now, the only difference between a grip and a tarluath is one more note, and that's lifting up this finger. So it's, I'll play that. That's the beginning of Scotland Bray that has a tour left right there at the beginning.